And here I am again with you, my dear brethren. In Jesus Christ, bringing to you about the perfect time of God in His time. There is always time. God is preparing for us His perfect will, His perfect time. This is what I was saying with my last video the other day, that about the permissible will and the God's will, God's perfect will. But before we are going to proceed with that topic, we are going to pray first. Father God in heaven, hallelujah. You created the angels to sing for you, O Lord, because this is what you want. This is what you love, to hear the sounds of the voice of the angels. That you need someone to sing for you. You give us voice to sing for you, Lord, O God. And you choose David as a king because he is a psalmist. Oh, hallelujah. That means that you love to hear the voice, because the voice is like a sweet sounds in our ears. I consider, Lord, that the ring is a music for me. Oh, glory to God. Okay. Help us, our way, I pray you, that this video that I am going to share, my brothers and sisters in Christ, bring them, and they are going to learn also to sing for you, because this is what you want, this is what you like, this is what you love, to hear the voices of your people. And this I pray to your Son, in Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. And here again, my dear brothers and sisters, I am going to sing for you this song. This is very familiar song for Christians. Hallelujah, oh God. And here I am going only to recall, because I really like the lyrics of this song. Hallelujah, oh God. You are going to sing with your heart giving to God. You make all things.
beautiful in your time. Lord, my life to you I bring, my song I have to sing, be to you a lovely
bless your name, O Lord.
Lord, please show me every day as you fit me your way, that you do just what you say in your time, in His time. In His time, Lord, please show me every day as you teaching me your way, that you do just what you say in your time, that you do just what you say in your time.
Oh, glory, hallelujah, oh God. Thank you so much, Lord, for this very nice morning with you again. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, glory. So there is nothing we can do, Lord, except to praise you, to bless your name, hallelujah, oh glory. This is why you made us to have a relationship with you, to sing for you, oh glory. And I am going to thank you, Lord, for having us a good voice. And I know, Lord, that even if we are not in a good tune with you, but I know that songs we are rendering to you today, this morning, give a sweet sounds in your ears. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to you, Lord. Thank you so much for understanding us, accepting us, even if I am not in a good tune, but I am trying my best to please you, my dear Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. My dearest brothers and sisters, this is my prayer for us all, that even if how many times we are going to stumble, but we are going to stand up and know that we are loved by God, because He taught us how to love others. He taught us firstly to to love Him back, how to love God. That is the greatest commandment that Jesus taught us. But it doesn't mean that we are going to forget the 10 commandments. Because Jesus, Yeshua, the Son of God, the only begotten Son of God, was already existed before time, the universe was created. A man was molded. The first man, Adam. And God created Eve to be a partner of Adam, to take care and manage the paradise garden of God. Praise the Lord. Oh, what a privilege was that. A privilege to our first parents on earth. They were the first man and woman created, molded by our God. And I have met one of this, not met personally, but I met him through online, of course. I have so many friends online. We were chatting through Messenger, that he said to me that he is not going to consider that Adam is our father. And I said to him, please read the first book, the Genesis, and so that you would know who is this first man created by God. And for that, we all came from them, from Adam and Eve. We are not going to deny that, because we are the seeds of Adam and Eve, and he escaped because he only knew Abraham. And I said to him, and where did Abraham came from? You should know that, because maybe he was only listening what the pastor said. But that's not the beginning. Abraham was only the beginning of faith, that God found grace with Abraham, and he became our father of faith. That is written in the book of Genesis. And you are going to, that is your assignment, you are going to find that what verse that Abraham became our father of faith. But Abraham came from Adam and Eve, and there is no other man, woman, that God created. We came from the two persons only, from Adam and Eve. And Eve became, that is in the Bible, in Genesis, the mother of all the living, of all that has breath here on earth. And because we have breath, we have this breathing, so we are going to call him mother. Mother Eve. We are not going to deny that. So we need to read the Holy Bible, the book of Genesis, so that Adam and Eve wouldn't become strange to us, whether we like it or not. Adam and Eve could be seen. In the judgment stand, they will be saved, of course. And it is the Lord God promised to Adam and Eve that after, during this rapture, of course, he is going to rapture. Caught up first, Adam and Eve. Because those are the two persons that the Lord God promised to them that I'm going put you back in the garden of paradise with your seeds. Hallelujah. Oh, what a wonderful promise with that. And since we are the seeds of Adam and Eve, we are the part of that salvation, the dying of Jesus on the cross. So it is clear that we are going to be with our first parent, Adam and Eve. Oh, glory. Oh, hallelujah. So now, my dear brothers and sisters, we are going to pray, because I am consuming my time already. Praying for you that, oh God, oh Father God, thank you so much, Lord, that there is always your time for us. Your time we are going to do. You have this perfect time for not, for we are not going to sin against you. Hallelujah. But this doesn't mean that if we are going to sin, you don't love us anymore. But still, you keep on loving us. Thank you so much for that, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. For your loving kindness to your people. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, God, I'm going to give you honor, glory, and thank you for everything through your Son, Jesus, Yeshua of Nazareth. Amen and amen. My dear friends, see you again. Praise the Lord. Love you as God loves us.